So I think so. Kalam Labs as a whole is a very compounding learning growth company where every one of us has started from practically zero. We also started from practically zero experience, and then we have grown up from that. So we really, really, appreciate people who like to grow, who like to be something which they are not already, always ambitious to be something, right?
Hey folks, welcome to First Check Portfolio Shorts. My name is Noah Martins, and this is a series where we speak to founders of our portfolio companies so that you get to know their team, understand what they're building, and the problem that they're trying to solve. If you like the content that we've been putting out, do like, share, and subscribe so that we can reach more founders and startup enthusiasts like you. Today's very special guest is Ahmed Faraz, co-founder of Kalam Labs. Kalam Labs is building a Twitch for science. It's a live game streaming platform that helps 6 to 14-year-old kids learn the science topics that they're most curious about, with weekly evaluations, live shows, and game-based puzzles. I had a really interesting conversation with Faraz, and he's working on a super interesting problem. So do stick around till the end of the episode. Thanks for doing this, Faraz. So let's talk about the problem that you're trying to solve.
Yeah. So Kalam Labs, it helps 6 to 14-year-old kids learn their favorite science topics using live gaming, right?
Okay.
So we have seen that kids are really fascinated about topics like black holes, alien life, time travel, etc. But the resources and the services which are available for that does not match it at all, right?
Right.
So we use a format which kids already love, that is live game streaming. And we use it in a way such that kids are able to learn all of these topics from their smartphones only.
So how did you all discover this problem?
Sure. So me, Sashakt, and Harshit, about 2 years of before starting up, we were at BITS Pilani, and we went off to work at India's largest education body, NCERT, right? We stayed at their headquarters. We built up an edtech app for them, interacted with kids, parents, and teachers. And there we basically saw this trend, which was that almost every kid from class first to eighth, they were really curious about these topics. And above all, they were primarily spending all their time on YouTube, either watching live game streams or exploring science topics, etc. So we just thought, why not amalgamate both and build up a platform around that.
Right. Okay, so tell me more about your solution. Like, for everybody who might not be familiar with Kalam Labs, what is the experience like for a user?
Sure. So it's pretty straightforward. What we have built is we have built a multiplayer game, right? And where you could do different kinds of science missions, you could build up your own civilizations, etc. However, the catch here is that every day at 6 p.m. IST, this game transforms into a live game streaming platform where an instructor comes in who plays the game and explains different science topics using it. Let's say, take the character across moon and then explain why does the moon have craters, right? Etc. like that. So kids could play the game with the streamer also and just learning newer and newer topics through it.
Nice. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
And so how far along are you at this point? How many games worlds do you have? How many people are using the platform right now? And is there any competition in this space?
So primarily we launched the product in end June. We currently have about 1,500 paying customers.
Nice.
They're all active on the platform. The live streams daily are regarding the worlds. We have created an entire solar system world where the character could move across the entire solar system up until from sun to Kuiper belt, everywhere can land up on Earth, Moon, Mars, has some three or four science missions as well. And the entire tech infrastructure of integrating multiplayer gaming and live game streaming, we have built all of that until now. So that's our progress regarding the product aspect. But apart from that, I could share about the funding as well, if that is counted as progress.
Sure.
Yeah. So primarily, we raised a pre-seed from Lightspeed and FirstCheck. And apart from that, after that we got into Y Combinator. After Y Combinator, we once again got funded by Lightspeed only, and with few other US angel investors and very eminent angel investors like Director of Engineering Roblox, Satish Subramaniam has invested, and co-founder and ex-CTO of Fubo TV. He has invested support Chui. Fubo TV is like the pioneer of live streaming, highly popular, listed in New York Stock Exchange. So they have invested. So that is like the complete progress of what all has happened at Kalam Labs till now.
And do you guys have any direct competition? Are there any other players who are doing something similar?
So as of now, I don't think so. There is any other edtech company who is specifically in this domain, which is outside the curriculum encyclopedia like science knowledge for kids.
Yeah.
At least here in India. Obviously, outside there is Magic School Bus, there is Stemworks, there is Tapiti, etc. But here in India, I think so, that's still a wide space. However, we are, it's quite inductive to think so, that it's just about time that some edtech company would, expand off to this particular space and launch their own science classes or something. So that's what it is. For that, we are thinking about it in a way that all this time we will be just focusing upon kids. That right. Kids should be loving to learn science here. And if we ace that, then we don't have to worry about competition or anything else.
Right. And you'll seem to be doing a pretty great job so far in that department. Yeah. Okay. Talk to me about yourself.
Yeah, I like to
and,
think so.
Yeah. Talk to me about yourself and your co-founders. Tell me your background and how you all met.
No. So we're all Bitsians, right? And we met at our college. That's as easy as that. I met Harshit when I was doing some Gen Chem lecture and Gen Chem extra lecture. After that, I met him. He was this really passionate about chemistry, asking all those questions which were not even in the syllabus. And I was there waiting on asking questions which can increase my marks. So that's how I met Harshit. I met Sashakt because when in our second year, me and Harshit, we started, okay, you're not, let's found a company, right? And at that time, startups were not even cool, right? I mean, that was not even considered an option. But we were like, yeah, you know what, let's do something around that. So regarding that, when we wanted to find someone who can do the technical work for us, as in like who can basically build the product, I was not that good in tech. So then we met Sashakt, who was also working on this tangential field of augmented reality. So that's how three of us came together. And it was a great bond. I mean, the moment we started, we got extremely serious about the startup. We were just traveling across to Delhi, meeting governments, etc. We were earlier a B2B, more like a company. So we just, did it more as an educational project for 2 years, then started doing it as a startup from January 2021.
Nice. All right. And could you tell me a little bit about why people should want to come and be a part of your team? I'm sure you're hiring and your company is growing. So what are some things that make Kalam Labs a good place to work?
Sure. What makes so? That's a good question. I can tell one anecdote, right? Obviously, I don't have things to say. So I can tell one anecdote. We are currently based out of Lucknow only, right, which is my hometown. So we have just taken 2-3 BHK flats here. So what happened was that back when I was a child, I've been living here only, and there used to be a kid of my house elf whom I was really good friends with. He was younger to me. He is currently about 18 years old, right? And when we started working out, he came off here only into the flat, and basically it's just helping out with the household chores and everything. But then what happened was that the culture of the startup got into him, or when we started to chat with him only, apart from that. But now, as of now, this guy Asif, what he is doing is that he is creating all the GIFs of our startup. And he has his own YouTube channel where he does live game streaming. He live game streams Minecraft. He has learned Photoshop, and he is posting different kinds of Photoshop videos, everything. And all that he has done without even having any background in English. He's operating all those softwares without having background in English. He started doing Duolingo just so as to learn all of that. So I think so. Kalam Labs as a whole is a very compounding learning growth company where every one of us has started from practically zero. We also started from practically zero experience, and then we have grown up from that. So we really, really, you know, appreciate people who like to grow, who like to be something which they are not already, always ambitious to be something, right?
Yeah.
So I think so. That's one of the places that if you like, if you would like to grow, if you would like to, you know, just keep pushing, but getting better, be one of the few places which you would like to visit.
That's awesome.
I
can tell that, you know, you seem like a team that has a very cool learning culture, and thank you for taking the time to talk to me.
Sure. And one more thing, Noah, as in yeah. One more cool thing is that one more thing because of which people should join us is that every day at 11:30 p.m. now we play CSGO as well.
Oh wow. Okay.
Yeah. So in, keeping the college culture alive as well. So playing CSGO, it's like a 1 hour gameplay. We played two exact games in St. Mark's and Dust 2.
Okay.
So that's a cool, it reminds you that you're still a kid trying to figure out.
Yeah. That's awesome. Yeah. So anyways, thank you for taking the time to talk to me. I wish you and your team all the best, and I can see you guys killing it.
Thank you.